Hi, in this video I'm going to talk about the process behind my drawings. I'm going to try going into some of the struggles that I've had with planning and artwork, the mindset that I use to overcome those struggles, and through that, just how I build up a composition for an artwork. Also, a huge thank you again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. The planning process, in my opinion, is the hardest part of creating an artwork. You very quickly become more comfortable with a pencil or a paintbrush, but the one thing that remains difficult or even gets harder through time is trying to plan artworks. There can be this crippling weight to perform, to try and create something better than what you've created before, or even just to try and live up to the success of a work that you've already done. Finding a starting point can be difficult. I think it's important to remember that it's a process. A mindset I used to try and help me was to go into it and deliberately up my failure rate. What I mean is to go into it and know that you're going to be deliberately failing. It's almost like you're cutting off the excess around a very vague idea that you have. And this is really helpful to just figure out what you don't want to do, what doesn't work, and to almost zero in on something that you think could work. Even if something only like 50% excites you, explore it a bit and find out at what point it fails to hold your attention. I can't even begin to tell you how frustrating it can be to try and plan a work that I really feel I can get behind. My whole life feels like it turns upside down. I often like call my mom or my friends and complain about how stuck I feel, especially after a week of planning where you think you've got something, and just to find that once you've kind of rendered it all out, it just falls flat. But the important thing is to just keep trying. Even though you're failing, you're still making progress. Finding something that excites you, that you can really sink your energy into, is so important. Okay, so a pretty big question I get asked quite often is if I work from reference photos, and if so, where I get my reference photos from. I do work from references, but more importantly, I take my own reference photos. The reason I think this is important is because it gives you so much control over your creative process. In my opinion, 60% of the work is done in the planning phase. I feel like you get a lot more honest and authentic the more involved you are in each step of the process. This isn't to say that using stock images is bad. I think that it's a really important stepping stone for figuring out what you like, what you don't like, and understanding lighting. I think if you're trying to put together a surreal composition and a lot of your elements have different lighting and perspective, you very quickly understand the value of being able to control these steps. I know for most of us, taking our own photos isn't really an option because buying a camera and camera equipment is so expensive. It was a huge deal for me when I invested in my first camera. That was about 10 years ago. But what's interesting is that my phone camera takes a lot better photos than that first camera I bought. The point of me saying this is that it might be more accessible for you to take your own photos than you think. This took me to the next important thing that I had to learn, and that was understanding the process of taking good reference photos. But first, let me give a quick shout out from this video sponsor, Squarespace. It goes a long way to help sustain this channel and to keep creating these videos, but more importantly, I'm really happy to work with this company because I think they can really benefit other artists and creatives looking to pursue a career in their field. It's so important to create an online portfolio to help clients find you and to provide an easy platform for clients to get in touch with you. And for me, I felt that Squarespace did that effortlessly. I never had to patch or upgrade anything. I could register my domain through them or set up an online store. And most importantly, I could design my own portfolio and show my work the way that I wanted to. And every time I got stuck, their amazing support team helped me out instantly. So if you're looking at building a website, give Squarespace a try. And if you decide that you love it, use this offer code and get 10% off your first purchase. Once I have an idea or a direction that I want to go in, I then have to start making preparations. Often this involves trying to scout out a scene or finding a nice tree or working with a florist, or a lot of my work involves figures. So I work closely with models to help me compose the artworks. Often this phase dictates more than I expect. There's a conversation that happens during the shoot. The model adds aspects to the scene which I couldn't plan for. I think it's important in this stage to leave room for the process, for the unexpected, to allow the composition to take its own course. You can always rein it back in if it strays too far from what you're trying to do, but I think the key here is to be open-minded. There's this great South African artist, William Kentridge, who talks about allowing the process to direct the work. And I found this to be so true. Often I'm pursuing a composition that just doesn't work. It feels like I'm swimming upstream. When I loosen up with my direction and allow the process to steer me a bit, often I find something that's a lot better than what I originally planned. To give an example of what I'm talking about here, in the planning for the drawing Restrained Eye Unravel, I had wrapped the model up in a lot of bandages. She was completely bound. but the composition felt claustrophobic and more uncomfortable to look at than what I intended. And I only realized this after I'd finished the shoot, so the planning for this piece was a failure. But the shot that called out to be worked on was one where the model was unraveling herself for the next pose. And this became the key that made the work successful. There was ambiguity between her either wrapping herself up or unraveling herself. There was space for her to breathe, and there was movement and tension. Allowing this unexpected shot to direct the rest of the composition opened up the whole work, and I had this feeling of, yes, this is exactly what I want to do. And I could see the finished piece clearly in my head. Another example of this is my most recent drawing return. I know a lot of you didn't like this piece because it's quite dark and uncomfortable to look at, but that's exactly what I loved about this piece. I love the discomfort it created, this feeling of almost intruding on a space that you aren't supposed to be in. The reference was taken almost accidentally between two poses as the model glanced back at me to hear what I was saying. This created a moment of tension that I could feel, that could be interpreted in so many ways. And from this point, I could drown the subject in darkness and add some of the visual vocabulary that I love so much to try and enhance what I'd already seen in the planning phase. Okay, so to sum up, it's about giving yourself space to find a theme that you can really get excited about. It's about embracing failure in the planning phase and not rushing through it, and having respect for how important this phase is, to try and keep your mind open and let the process guide you a little bit. So yeah, I hope you found this video helpful. Leave a like if you did, and I'd love to hear what your process and planning is and what your struggles or how you've overcome those struggles might be. So let me know in the comments, or let me know what you'd like me to talk about in the next video. But thank you so much for the support. This community has been amazing. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.